What if there was a platform out there that you could reach roughly 30% of Australians aged over the age of 18 without having to spend any dollars on advertising? That's what TikTok is today, and that's what we're talking about. Welcome to my webinar. I'm Liam Fahey from the Digital Solutions Program, and I'm going to be talking on how not to dance and get likes on TikToks in our today's webinar, Don't Dance for Likes. So I created this workshop because there is a misconception that to get popular and get found on TikTok, you have to dance. Someone like me who has two left feet and can't follow a beat really has no hope on this platform. Yet I've gone viral multiple times with over, you know, 250,000 views on one video. For the clients that I've worked with, they have received millions of views from TikTok videos, all without spending any dollars on advertising. So TikTok is really an incredible platform to go viral. So I'm Liam Fahey. I'm a content creator with about 14 years experience in the industry. I've been consulting with the Digital Solutions Program for about 7 years now. And I'm based in the regional city of Rockhampton in central Queensland. I am one of the largest marketing production companies in Queensland. It's called Layered Social. And my team spend all day, every day, producing content for other businesses, for brands across the country, across the state, and across our local area, working with small business right up to national companies and everything in between. The idea of today's workshop, I'm going to take you through how TikTok works, how to create content, what you need to go viral, what's trending, and why you need to be on TikTok now. Simple answer for why you need to be on TikTok now is because it has huge potential to reach your audience. So with today's webinar, if you are attending it live, if you have a question at any point in time, in the bottom of your Zoom controls, you will see the question and answer button and the chat button. Feel free to use either of these to ask questions, and I'll do my best to answer them as we go along. If you're watching this video later online, feel free to reach out to me at Business Station and ask some questions. I'm more than happy to answer them most of the time. So, TikTok, what makes it different from every other platform that's out there? If you post content to Facebook, it works by the amount of people that engage with you. Engagement being likes, tags, shares, comments, clicks. The people that engage with you will see your content. With Instagram, it's the same thing, people that engage with you, but also whether or not they follow those hashtags. With TikTok, which is, I reckon, is the most exciting platform out here now, it works by sending out your video to a small audience. If that small audience likes your video and engages with it by liking, tagging, sharing, commenting, clicking, replaying, downloading, duetting, there's a few different things you can do with TikTok, then what happens is it goes out to a slightly bigger audience. If that bigger audience engages with it, sends it to a bigger one, and a bigger one, and a bigger one, bigger, 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 and so forth. So it's entirely possible that you could put up your first video today and have over 1 million views on it by the end of the week. And those 1 million views do translate to dollars in the till. I'm going to show you a few examples of that today. This workshop is going to be very live and interactive in that we're going to be looking at real content in real time. So I have no idea what's going to be displayed when I start looking through the For You feed, which I'm also going to explain. So content warning. Starting with a little bit of statistics. There's around about 7.5 million active users in Australia over the age 18 on TikTok. The average Australian spends 23 and a half hours a month on TikTok. That's a 40% increase from last year. Last year, TikTok was the second most downloaded app in Australia. The only one that beat it out, I can't remember exactly which one it was, but it was one of the COVID apps. And there's around about 26 million people in Australia and 7.5 million of them on TikTok, so you can reach about 30% of them. So let's jump in, let's go live, and let's actually see what TikTok is all about. So I'm going to get my screen shared and share the scene. Okay, so here we are on TikTok. This is the desktop version. It's definitely designed for the mobile version, but I can't show you that easily, so we're going to look at this one today. So first of all, This is the For You feed. You can see I'm in there. So down here is going to be a random selection of videos based on what TikTok thinks I'm already interested in, things I've interacted, sounds I've interacted with. But it's also going to have videos with people I've never seen before. So this one, making this chocolatey thing, never seen this one before. I've seen things like this before. But you can see it's already very engaging because it's different. It's unique. The next section down is the following. So these are people that I'm actively following from my account. And then we have lives. Lives are active videos that are going on, much like you have on Facebook. So very interesting with this one. I'm actually going to have a look at this video. This is a creator that I do like, and I've seen their stuff. So let's play it out. I keep going till I crash, even then I hit the gas. I ain't stopping, that's a fact. Got some heaters in the stash, just in case they wanna ask. I could show them where I'm at, do my verse, and then I dip out. I had to stick out, a copy in the script now. So he's a rapper. He does these sort of style of videos, but he also has another style of video, which is rather quite unique. I'm gonna find one of the good ones.
Ready to go? Bro, we're kind of in the middle of something.
I have a date.
You got a date? I mean, yeah, of course you got a date. What's the problem?
She wants to go dancing.
And?
I don't dance.
Oh, come on, dude. Everyone can dance.
Yeah, you just got to let loose, man. Let the music move you.
I don't follow. I got an idea. Play the song.
The song?
The song.
Feeling so tall, I could give a high five to the pilot. So he does these sort of style of videos where he basically cuts from three different versions of himself to tell a story, and they're generally quite engaging. It gets a lot of attention. This one over 7.5 million views. For artists, he was essentially unknown before he went live on TikTok, and now he's trending. So there's a lot of opportunity there, and with TikTok, you'll find
so I designed this
different types of videos. This one I've actually seen before with various different styling, but the main idea here is to show things that are unique and different. So let's go on to another example here. One of the things with TikTok that's very important is the sound. TikTok was originally a merger between a music platform and sort of a dance platform that became TikTok. So sound's always had a very strong origin in this platform. And if someone's already listened to a sound, and these sounds, you can load them on when you upload your video. If someone's already listened to that sound, there's a high chance that your video is going to play if it's a trending sound. So we have our audio here. We have our likes. We have our comments. This one was a trend going back a little while ago that's rather quite popular. And it is actually one of the dance on TikTok for the trend. But let's have a look at it. So this was one of the trends that went there, and if we were to click on the audio file, you can see all the videos that use that audio, and there is literally hundreds. The scrolling is unlimited, it's infinite. There is probably a million videos using the sound. 7.9 million videos to be exact. But you don't always have to dance to get attention and to draw people into your business. So let's go to a real world example. This is Millennium Comics and Collectibles based in Rockhampton. This store, this is actually the owner here, is the largest pop culture store in the Southern Hemisphere. Now, going back a start of the year, we set up a TikTok for them. And the first couple of videos got a couple hundred views. And then we had one that went viral, 96,000 views. This translated into around about, I think it was 80,000 or so visits through to our website over the course of January. We had a few other videos that did well in January, like 11,000 views, 12,000 views, those sort of things. So let's have a look at this trend. This is definitely Don't Dance for Likes.
Series based on comics. Lock and Key. The Witcher. Netflix series based
on... Very, very simple sort of trend, and we followed it up with doing part two, part three, part four. If you find something that works, keep doing it. If your audience engages with it, keep doing it. Generally, once we find a trend and something that people like, you repeat it until it stops working. One of the things that we did was we had our copy, a bit of wording, and then we had a few hashtags. So with the hashtags, we used popular hashtags, and we also used a tag for our actual business. So we created a hashtag that's relating to a business so we can keep track of all the videos that use that tag. Using this particular tag, as you can see, we've got 161,000 views on it.
Netflix series based on comics, Sweet Tooth.
So none of the filming here is anything complicated, but this did lead to direct sales. So it can be done very simply without dancing. Okay, on to our next example. Now, this one is a bit closer, is also here in Australia. This is a mechanic, and his name's Pokey. He's down in Tasmania, and his entire marketing is based around TikTok, and I'll let him explain it to you.
I work on basically, I would estimate maybe, and I don't reckon it's even this high, would be 1% would be in my area, our followers on TikTok. It may be a little bit higher, it might be lower. That's 1,450 people. If I get half of them as customers, I'm doing amazingly well, and this makes this worthwhile. A lot of my customers tell me they come from seeing us on TikTok, and yeah. It's working. Saying that, would I be able to service 100,000 followers? No shop in Australia can handle that. So no, I wouldn't be doing that. But most of the customers, most of the people following me aren't from this area locally, but a small percentage of them are. But that small percentage, even if it's only 1%, is more than I can handle. So yeah, that's how my marketing works. All right,
If that's clear enough, he purely just does TikTok, and the very small percent of his followers, and at the time he had 100,000 followers, if just 1% of them are in his local area, that's more work than he can handle. So even if you get people viewing your videos from anywhere in the world, as long as you get a small percentage in your area or in your market, you're doing well. So I just want to go through his videos because he's a mechanic. He's not doing anything flash with his editing, his filming. It's either him pointing the camera at himself or someone pointing a camera at him. So I'm just going to pick a video randomly.
All right, finally, the 79 series is ready to go out the door. I need to do a video on it so you guys get to see it, hear it, and get to see the final product. So first of all, the turbo is a Garrett higher output turbo, 30% higher output than standard. Then we're on to the exhaust system that comes out 2.5 inch out of the back of the turbo into a reducer to 4.5 up all the way.
Talks about all the different parts. And you get to hear the beautiful noise. So this is one of his longer videos, but his approach to it is mostly just him pointing the camera either at what he's talking about or at himself. There's nothing complicated there with the editing. It's something that everyone can do rather quite easy. The thing that he does well, and if this is your first takeaway, is that he takes the customers behind the scenes and shows them what actually goes on. A lot of us, our business stops at the front camera. That's as far as our customers ever see. Everything that happens behind that reception desk in business is completely mundane to us because we do it every single day. But as soon as we start taking our customers behind the scenes, it's new to them because they might not have any experience or any familiarity with what they're looking at. So just because it's boring for you, doesn't mean it's not interesting for your customers. So I generally recommend that you start showing customers what you actually do. Take them behind the scenes, introduce your team. And with the example of Pokey, the mechanic down in Tasmania, he's got 169,000 followers now that watch him in his wild mechanical work. Sometimes it's rather quite simple, some of it's complicated, but he has people that travel from all over Australia now just to get him to work on their car. He gets people that go looking for him and to want to work for him just because of what they've seen online. And as I mentioned before, it's simple. None of it's complicated. There's nothing really out there as far as editing goes. So let's go far now. This example, we're going to look at America. So this guy is Cheese Boss, Jim. Well, I'll let him tell his story. This one is what we call the dreamer market. Everyone always has that dream with, you know, if I quit my day job and started a business, how successful could it be? I think that's the dream most of us have, which is why we are in business. Or you're like me, where you're pretty much completely unemployable. So let's have a look what he has to say.
Everything behind to start the next big. So 1 year ago, I left everything behind to start the next big restaurant brand. We started off small with this plot of land and built everything we could by ourselves. We got this trailer to start and get proof of concept out to the people as fast as we could. We built everything and made it look really awesome and nice. But then we had to close. Shortly after, we managed to lease out this restaurant space and we built it up by hand ourselves. Piece by piece, wall by wall, hour by hour, day by day, we built it up and we finally got open. And this is where our story begins. This is us. So
this was his story. This sort of thing, most of it is just photos. So it's not overly complicated. And he's just put a voiceover over the top of it. We call this B-roll. And we have content where it's not a talking head. That's the industry name. And voiceover over the top, rather quite simple. If we have a look at the rest of his videos, a lot of them, again, are just a talking head and him showing things. So I'm going to pick one at random.
This is the quesadilla. And it's called that because it's only a dollar. What's in the quesadilla? Well, it's a flour tortilla, some shredded cheddar. It gets perfectly melted. And what's this sauce? It's the secret sauce. If you could guess what it is, put it in the comments. Of course, I definitely had to try it. Probably should have waited a little bit for it to cool off, but it was so good. So
quite simple. And a lot of his videos are like that, and he gets 10, 20,000 views on each of them, some are a little bit more fun. So you might be thinking, how can I relate these to my industry? And do feel free to drop in the chat what type of business you actually are, and I'll give you some examples. But it's always worthwhile.
So 1 year.
Okay, let's have a look here and see what he's used. So he's used hashtag small business. Let's click on that. And here's a whole heap of examples from people in small business, various different types. There's ideas they can always look. So Amy is a sunscreen brand. Hey, very exciting, Amy. I've actually been working with a pharmaceutical company out of Perth where I've been creating some content for them. We're actually just talking about TikTok today for their brand. Okay, so I'm just going to type in sunscreen Australia, and here's a heap of videos of people doing things with sunscreen. Lots of different ideas here. Pick one, have a look to see what they do. If you see one that's got a lot of views, then it might be a good example of what you can do.
You might have heard that Australian sunscreens are the best in the world, and here's why.
This one has over 100,000 views on it. Okay, let's have a look at another example here. So marinated olives and olive wood charcoal products. Hey, Sam and Tony, don't know which one it is or it's both of you, but that sounds really exciting. I like the sound of that one. With that one, I would show the different processes for marinating your olives. I have no idea how you'd actually marinate an olive. So if we don't know how to do something, that's something exciting that you can showcase on TikTok. You can also showcase how you could use the different marinated olives. Shelly is a virtual assistant. Okay, your one's a little bit more interesting. As soon as you get into a service-based business, it's a little bit more difficult to show because you don't have a physical product there in front of you. With a virtual assistant, what I'd recommend is first I'd showcase your office, you know, what you like about it, the different sort of virtual assistants sort of work you do. I'm assuming that you probably work from home, so you know, your office pet that comes in and gets you company, your coworker, those sort of things. Have a look to see what other virtual assistants do on TikTok for ideas. Alison is a hypnotherapist, and I believe I was actually talking to Alison earlier today. I think I recognise the last name, might be the same one I was talking to. I would probably make a bit of a joke about hypnotherapy being about dance like a, or squawk like a chicken, bark like a dog, but then go on to explain what it actually is. So having a assistant victim that you can film and hypnotize them and show what it actually is would be very entertaining. Or you could actually do sort of a cut footage where you film yourself and then film yourself again as a actor character role. The Lee is container for change site. Okay. I'd probably showcase what the container is used for, the different types, explain a little bit more, show a little bit of the behind the scenes action of what happens once your container arrives to site. Some of these are a little tricky, I love it. Ryan is Hawaiian shirts and men's apparel. How do you style a Hawaiian shirt to make it look better? If you're not in Hawaii and origin of the shirts, your designs, men's apparel, so you can go deeper into that. So upstyling, downstyling shirts, different ways to wear them. Tanya is a dietitian who does early life nutrition and books products that support parents introduce healthy food to their kids. I'm wondering if Tanya, if you're someone else I've already consulted with, because again, that one sounds very familiar. With that one, I would probably showcase some of the nutritional advice from your book in the real world, and yes, it is, you're cool, and showcase kids actually enjoying the healthy foods and why it's good for them and what the difference is between foods. Actually, I'm going to show a really good example shortly of one of my own personal videos where you can showcase the difference with nutritional value and generally non-nutritious food has a lot of calories for the weight of the food and the size of the food. So I've got a really good example that I'll use shortly. Susie is premium honey. I've actually been consulting with a honey business recently. So, and my dad is a beekeeper, so I do have some personal experience around that one. But I would showcase the all that exciting bee knowledge. So what goes on when you go to a hive, how you get them not to eat the hell out of you or sting the hell out of you. Collection of the honeys, the different colours of the different sort of flowers or plants that they collect the pollen from. There's a few different things that you can showcase there, right down to the packing, your personal favourite way to enjoy the honey, whether it's on toast, how dark the toast needs to be. There's lots of different ways that you can explore video. So at this point in time, I'm going to jump onto my own personal TikTok page, and I'm going to show you a couple of examples of videos, including one where I went viral. And I do a few different styles of videos. Essentially, nothing I do, and it's my personal TikTok, has anything to do with my work. It's just a bit of fun most of the time. So let's jump on. Okay, so series of different videos, travel, planes. If you can't tell from my screensaver, I do like to fly. So a lot of my videos are me playing around in my little plane. Always good fun. But some of them are a little bit more action oriented and trendy.
I work a job. I'm an adult. I work a job. I get paid for that job, and then I use that money to buy childish things like this.
So one of my exciting Lego videos. And when you have these, you've got your analytics, so you can actually view how popular they are. This is the same if it's a personal account or a business account. So you can see who's viewing it, where they're viewing it from. So as you can see, around about 50% of my audience is from Australia, and you'll tend to find that will always be the same. You get about 50% of your audience. This sort of little video with my Lego D11 has reached 1,800 people, 12% watched it before, an average watch time, total watch time. So there's a little bit of information you can glean from the analytics. If we go to one of my more popular videos, and just, I'm going to forewarn this one. I was challenged by a friend to go viral. I said, it's so easy, let me show you. So I picked one of the easiest ways to do it. And just before I get into that, we have a question from the audience, and I'm probably going to butcher this name, so I'm not going to try. But yeah, this is my name and this is my profile. If you click on the edit profile, you can change your username and your display name. So this is my nickname, this is my username. My username makes up my handle. In the bio, you can have things like the links through to your website, your link tree, your contact email, whatever you would like. So that's all in the edit your profile. Okay, so jumping into this video. And the reason why this works is because I allowed for controversy, and I'll go into detail after we watch it.
What is the weight difference between regular and large fries? ...117 grams for regular. 130 to grams for large. What the 15 grams difference looks like in said looking fry.
Now, my mate was wondering why this works. And it works because it gives people the opportunity to go, hey, Jim, zero it out, the bowl's way different, all those things. It's not a technically perfect video and attracts a lot of attention. I redid this video this time with KFC, but I showed everything and 250,000 views, 3,500 views.
What is the weight difference between KFC large and regular chips? 111 grams for regular. 248 grams for large. This is what the 137 grams difference looks like. What is the weight?
So for our nutritionists watching, you could do, this is a chip from fast food company. This is how many calories it has. This is how much it weighs. This is the value. This is nutritionist food. This is the value, etc. So there's an idea for you. So. You can see that as soon as I showed everything, there was no opportunity for the troll.
What is the weight?
Trolls are incredibly powerful to generate interest and get people moving forward. You know, everyone's got an opinion. If you get those opinions on it, it makes a big difference. And as you get people commenting on it, other people can look at the comments and it goes through. So like this person's like, you should use the same bowl as the weight, the bowl varies. So that these sort of things encourage that communication. If we have a look at the analytics for this video.
Weight difference between.
There you go. Most of them seen it in the For You page. They're following me, so it just came up as they're scrolling. The only 30% watched it before. I had 227,000 people that reached it. And 26% of my audience was Australian, 21% United Kingdom, and so forth. Now, funnily enough, a large European audience, you are going to get more in English-speaking communities, but the crazy bit was the 360 shares. So we have a question as well about the username. So I'm just going to go back to my account there, so explain the username. The question is, can I use the same username for all my social networks, or is it better to use a different one? If you can get the same username, use the same username just because it's familiar across all the brands. So I'd recommend the same username across all your handles if you can do it. And the second question is it good or bad to use the same email to register on social networks? It's For ease of access, it's probably a good idea to use the same email. If that email ever gets compromised, all your accounts are compromised. So that's something that you have to weigh up. With any social platform that you use, it's always a great idea to set up two-factor authentication, because with two-factor authentication, it's an extra step that anyone who's trying to do something malicious with your account has to go through. Generally, as soon as it's difficult, they will choose something easier or someone easier to go on to. So two-factor authentication goes a long way. Now, for most of these videos that I'm showing you today, you'll notice that they have a lot of them are filmed in that their videos. There's only a couple that I showed you where they had photos, most of them are videos. So video is often a difficult challenge for most people in business. You're very good at what you do, but how to actually shoot video is a difficult one. Now, as painful as it is for me to say this as a content creator, someone who, you know, has a team of people that work for me that professionally create content, but essentially every single business out there can create content using this device. If you have a mobile phone, anything in the last 5 years to even as far away as 10 years that can shoot good video or even average video, then you have more than enough to actually create good content for social media. When we start looking at video, the most important thing, first of all, is audio. Now, I'm going to take you through a couple of tricks here. So, first of all, it's a good idea to figure out where the microphones actually are on your mobile device. Now, if you have a rear-facing camera and front-facing camera, which I assume most of you will, the microphone will actually be in different locations, potentially. My one, I have a microphone at the top and a microphone at the bottom, depending on which camera I'm using. So what I recommend that you do is you put your phone on recording, put it on the front-facing screen, and move your phone around the outside while you're talking, saying my fingers at the top, coming around the outside. And where the audio gets muted is where your microphone is. So don't put your hands over the microphone. And naturally, keep the hands away from where the camera is. So that's the first tip to get good quality audio. The next tip is to start using some microphones. There's a few different microphones you can go to at various different prices. And I'm going to just get my screen shared here so you can see it. As you can see, various different types, including little ones that can plug into your phone. Now, this type of microphone that you see here, these ones are all shotgun microphones. Shotgun microphones, the closer you are to them, the less audio around it gets. As you get further and further away, the audio spreads out like a shotgun pattern. They're reasonably good quality audio, and there's various different styles that you can get, including just straight clip lines. The next type up from that is where we move into a lapel microphone. Now, depending on the quality of these, they're generally what we call omnidirectional microphone, and that they'll pick up audio from around the actual microphone. Omnidirectional microphones, especially high quality ones, are definitely a good idea. Professionally, I use these ones, these road links, the little square, clip it onto your shirt, you get incredible audio. I'm really focusing here on audio because if you have bad video or shaky footage or bad lighting or bad composition, as long as you have good audio, your video is generally accepted. If the audio quality is bad, then it's a worse user experience for your customers. So a lapel microphone or even a shotgun microphone really increases the quality of your audio. Just using audio, for example, if I switch from my desktop microphone, this beautiful Yeti microphone, to my webcam microphone, you're going to notice that the audio quality is going to change. So I've just switched it then. I'm sure I sound a lot worse than I did a few moments ago. So let's switch that back. So audio quality is important. If you've got headphones with your mobile phone, what you can always do is plug your headphones in. It's got a little microphone on it. Bring that up and clip the microphone part to your shirt. Take the actual headphones and just tuck them inside your shirt, and it'll act as a lapel microphone. Nice, cheap and easy. You can even get an adapter cable to extend that microphone. So that is a cheap and easy way to do it. When you're listening to audio, I'm sure you've all heard wind noise. Wind noise sort of cuts out the audio, makes it sound worse. So with that, what I recommend you do is you get dead cat. Now that's an industry term. They're also called wind socks. Most microphones, if you spend more than $100, will probably come with the option for a dead cat. A dead cat is a sock that goes over your microphone and takes out the wind noise. These are something that I definitely recommend to improve your audio quality, especially if you're doing a lot of outside shooting. So after we have good quality audio, the next bit is to have nice, stable footage. Now you can buy stabilizers and there's various different types, the biggest brand being DJI. I believe their stabilizers start around about $100 that give you nice smooth motion. But if you're outside your budget, what you can always do is take your mobile phone, take your hands, lock them down to your side. And that's going to give you very stable footage even when you're walking around. So that's really good if you're filming someone. If you have someone that can film you, there's a few techniques that we use here. If you have your subject and your cameraman, your camera person, have one of them moving or both of them moving, but never have both still. Perfectly still footage becomes really, really boring. If I'm just standing here as a talking head for an hour on a webinar, it's not going to be as exciting as me showing you videos and showing you examples of different work that you can do, bobbing around, moving a little bit. So you ideally want to have your camera in movement or yourself in movement. So there's also a few options with that, which we can combine with improving our lighting, which is the last step for the video. Ring lights are a really good, cheap, easy way to improve the quality of your video. And you can also get a stand that you can mount your mobile phone in. As you can see, you can get them for rather cheap, from $12 up to hundreds of dollars. But a nice simple setup here from Kmart or Big W will probably be more than enough for most general users. And then you can set your phone up and move towards it. That's going to give you a very dynamic video, which is going to make it more interesting than if you're just standing completely stationary. Okay, so that has covered rather quite quickly this time most of the content that I like to do in Don't Dance for Likes on TikTok. If anyone has any questions, now is always a really great time to throw it at me. Just going to quick look through my notes here. With going viral on TikTok, have a look to see what's trending. If you can find something that other people are doing, it's a great way to jump onto the bandwagon, especially if you can pick sounds that are trending. We have a fantastic question here from Alison. She's asked, how long should a video go for? Generally, when you're first starting out, I recommend going for a shorter amount of time. If you can do a video for less than 30 seconds, it's going to be more effective than a video that's 3 or 10 minutes long. So keep it short. I like to recommend 15 seconds is always a good number. And actually, this is where a lot of people tend to come unstuck. They try and sell everything in 15 seconds. Way back in the day with a TV commercial, it was 15 seconds. Yeah, you could only just sell one thing or you tried to cram everything into that one 15 seconds. The great thing about social media is you can just sell one message. That's all you need to sell. Because you can always put up a video the next day or even an hour later where you can sell a different message. When you are creating content on social media, and this is regardless of what platform it is, I recommend that you do four sort of styles of posts. The first style is a branding post. Branding posts are all about who you are, what you do, what your values are, what makes you different, the people in your business. I essentially take branding and go, who are you and why should I care? That is branding. With the right branding, you can influence the perception of people. Regardless of what brand it is, we all have personal opinions towards it, even if it's subconsciously. Great example of branding is Android versus Apple. I'm a Samsung user every day of the week because this is my connection to the world as a business owner. And I could not handle having a cracked screen. Every iPhone I've ever seen always has a cracked screen. So I think iPhone, I think cracked screens. For me, Samsung is trust. So that's how I feel about the brand. So branding's our first type of post. A second type of post I like to do is capability posts. Capability posts often get confused with sales. With a capability post, you're purely just trying to show, you're not trying to sell anything. So just let them know what you're capable of doing. Whether you're a service business or a product business, if you're a product one, it's this is our product, this is what's great about it. Action posts are where you say, hey, click on the link, go through to our website, buy a product, get in touch with us, we want to collab, whatever it is. With action posts, you're asking your customer to do something. The final type of post is the social testimony. This is where you get your customers to create content for you or go, Liam really loves this product, whatever it is, get something with your customers involved to give proof towards your product. So those are the four types of posts: branding posts, capability posts, action posts, and social testimony ones. Okay, Amy's got a question here, which is, how do I link a shop to TikTok? With TikTok, you are allowed one link. So if I load my example, as you can see with Millennium Comics, we have a link through to their website. When you go into your edit profile, whether you're on the desktop version or the mobile version, there'll be an option to edit profile. Click on that and you'll be able to put a link here in your bio or in your link field. So that's how you do that. Next question. Do serious video get much leverage, or do people find them boring? You can do a serious video and still make it interesting. It just depends on how you approach it visually. I have a bunch of people that work for me that create content for video all day, every day, including a guy who's worked on everything from Lord of the Rings, The Hobbit, through to Survivor, Married at First Sight, The Block. So he's really, really high up in his field. But all that expertise is technical. I employ people based on their ability to think creatively. So I employ people if they can come up with ideas. So if you can't come up with ideas, have a look around. But the other thing you could do is you could always turn to the TikTok Creator Marketplace. TikTok Creator Marketplace is kind of like a shopping center for influencers and creators on TikTok. So you can come on here, pick a creator that you like, get in contact with them, and essentially get them to produce videos for you. So that is always an option. Alternatively, jump on and partner with a creative studio, production house, that can do the same sort of thing, more local to your region. Next question down. Okay, so Ryan's asked the question, where do I find the pre-recorded B-roll or change the caption voiceover? So you film the B-roll, the footage that you want to put over the top, or the photos that you want to put over the top. So do that with your mobile phone, your camera, collect it from somewhere. When you upload your videos, and I recommend using the mobile to upload it, it'll give you a lot of different options there for editing, splicing, changing your footage. The editing app with TikTok is absolutely incredible. It's probably the best platform I've seen for editing since iMovie first came out, since Premiere Pro first came out. So it's incredible. It's industry quality editing. Now, inside those, you'll have the option to add text, and there'll be an option there for voiceover. Have a little bit of a play for the settings, you'll find it. And there's different voices you can choose from as well. So I used a voiceover with the McDonald's video. Okay, Alison has the question. Should you start with a couple of serious videos and then go more fun? Because you have the for you and you have the following. If people follow you, the more likely they see your videos. But there's always going to be a random selection of people that are going to get your videos when you post them. So there's not really a strategy or a system that you have to follow. What I recommend is you try a few different styles of videos and see what people jump onto. When you get something that people connect with and jump on, keep doing those videos or that style of video until your customers stop engaging with you. Then it's time to change and update the plan. It's sort of very much audience feedback. As a producer, I will sit down with my team, come up with 50 ideas for 50 videos for a business. Then I'll go into that business with my team and I'll shoot those 50 videos. Of those 50 videos we shoot, 30 might get take off and get a couple thousand views on them. 10, you know, might get 20, 30 views on them, no one cares. But we always have those couple golden videos that get, you know, hundreds of thousands of views on them. So it's more of a numbers game. Produce enough content and eventually you're going to get seen. Just because simply you get a random viewing of people. What I definitely recommend with is the first 5 seconds of your video is the most important. So don't do the very stereotypical, hey guys, today on today's show, blah, blah, blah. Start with something interesting. If you think back to the start of this video, for those that were on time when we started, I started with TikTok's a platform that you can reach 30% of the market in Australia over the age of 18. I'm going to show you how to do that today. I'm Liam Fahey. So I started with something that was interesting, a detailed fact, before I got into the actual introduction. With TikTok, there is tagging others. It works exactly the same as every other platform. Use the at symbol, put the name, their handle, and you'll be able to tag them. Okay, some absolutely fantastic questions from the audience. If you've got some other questions, throw them at me now. But while we're doing that, I just want to let you know about the Digital Solutions Program. At the start of this workshop, I told you that I contract for Business Station and deliver the Digital Solutions Program. So what is it? The Digital Solutions Program is a program that's funded by the Federal Government of Australia to assist businesses. What you can do is you can get 3 hours of one-to-one business advice and 4 hours of workshops and webinars, over $1,000 of value, and it only costs you $44. So what you can do is you can sign up for the Digital Solutions Program. Just type in Digital Solutions into your Google, type in Business Station as well to land on our program. If you're in Queensland, WA or NT, you've just got to have a valid ABN that's registered, have fewer than 20 employees and be operating to make a profit, which I'd say most if you are. Sign up is really simple and easy. And this is a new landing page. That button is not actually working yet, so I'm going to let them know about that. But if you click this button up here, you'll come to our other version of that landing page. Click on the register for this program. And this is the form. It is really quite simple to do. The hardest bit is knowing your ABN. With that, you can get some one-on-one time with an advisor like myself. Generally, with most sessions, I like to go through things like your website, social media. I like to work with you to develop a content plan, different ideas of what you can be actually posting throughout the year. So for most businesses I work with, the end goal is to come up with a 26-week plan of what you can be posting. I find that's most useful for most businesses. But there is definitely lots of different things that you can learn for our program. So if you're not already part of the Digital Solutions Program, I recommend jumping onto Digital Solutions Business Station and signing up for our program. If you have any questions about it, do feel free to get in touch with Business Station or myself. That concludes our webinar today on Don't Dance for Likes on TikTok. If you do have any questions, I will remain on for a few minutes. Otherwise, let me know what was the most useful thing that you learned in today's webinar. This feedback is always useful for me because it allows me to better improve it the next time I do this webinar. If there's something that I went through and I went through a little bit too fast, don't worry, this will be live on our Business Station YouTube page, so you'll be able to watch it again. There's also hundreds of videos available to you on our YouTube channel, so jump onto YouTube, type in Business Station, and have a look at the range of different things that you can learn. So I've been Liam Fahey from the Digital Solutions Program on behalf of Business Station, and what I want you to remember is you don't have to dance for likes on TikTok.